work power and energy. First most question to be attempted, like physical world and measurements. So first of all, work done by a force is given by, if force is constant, then simply force dotted with displacement. Sometimes forces are given in terms of 3i cap, 4j cap, minus k cap. Take the dot product. In case force is variable, may be time dependent, it may be dependent on x also, then integral force dotted with small displacement dx. Or you may have to change sometimes limits to time limits. If force is time dependent, then express displacement as a function of time. Take the dot product. You may have to proceed both with integration as well as dot product. You may be given force varies as x square I cap and something x into j cap. Some function of x in terms of vectors also. Take the dot product. Power. Power is either work done per unit time or dw by dt. If expressed as force dotted with displacement, displacement divided by time is velocity. So force dotted with velocity is also one of the relations to be used. Work done by centripetal forces, work done by cooling. Studying from class 9, 0, and work done by all resistive forces which are against the motion is always negative, but work done due to friction can be positive. As you walk on ground, you are pushing the ground backwards, you get a forward reaction due to friction. So frictional force is in forward direction. And motion is also in forward direction. So when force and displacement in the same direction, that means work done is positive work. So friction can do positive work. Resistive forces which are opposing the motion, they would always do a negative work. First question. A block of mass M is kept on a platform which is rising up from rest with constant upward acceleration g by 2. What is the work done by normal reaction on the block in t second? So simple. We have discussed the case of lift. When lift is accelerating up, reaction is given by
g plus a.
Now a is g by 2. So m bracket g plus g by 2. How much? 3mg by 2. That is reaction. Since the lift starts from rest, initial velocity was 0. That means displacement covered in t second. Displacement covered in t second. S equal to ut plus half a t square. How much? U 0, 0 to 0, half g is not g here acceleration is g by 2, half g by 2 t square, that is g t square upon
4.
And now g t square by 4 is displacement, and reactional force is three mg by two into half gt, sorry, into gt square by four. Multiply these two. Force into displacement, constant force. How much?
three m g square t square by eight.
Any doubt? Another question. Work done is equal to area under force displacement graph. Force may be constant, force may be variable. applicable in both situations. A particle moves in one dimension from rest under the influence of a force that varies with distance as shown in the figure. Kinetic energy of the particle after it has traveled 3 meters. Okay. If you divide it into boxes, each box is 1 by 1. 1 into 1. 1, 2, 3, 4. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
5, 6. And?
6.5.
Half. Is it half?
Yes.
6.5. 6.5 joule of work is done. Was there any initial kinetic energy?
No.
So work done is equal to area under the graph, and work done is equivalent to change in
change in energy
or it may be any other energy also. So change in energy. So initial energy was zero. That means the final kinetic energy is zero plus work done. So work done is 6.5 joule. I think not difficult. Another situation. A force acts on a 2 kg object so that its position is given as a function of time, x equal to 3t square plus 5. If position varies with time as a quadratic function of time, like ut plus half t square, in that case acceleration is uniform. So this is a case of uniform acceleration. If acceleration is uniform, that means force equal to m into a is also constant, and work done by constant force is simply force into displacement. So one of the methods would be, let's write position as 3t square plus 5. First derivative, velocity equal to
6t.
Second derivative, acceleration?
6.
6. Acceleration is 6. So one of the methods is you find what is the displacement covered. S equal to ut plus half t square. As done here. V 6t, acceleration 6, force equals mass into acceleration. Mass is 2 kg. 6 into 2, 12 newton. Displacement covered in 5 seconds. Because we are supposed to find what is work done by this force in first 5 seconds. So be careful. If you just substitute x equal to 5 here, then it gives the new position of the object, not displacement. X at 5 seconds is not displacement, it is position. Because at x equal to 0 second, it wasn't at origin. At 0 second, position is 5 meters. So, that those 5 meters are to be subtracted. It has already covered 5 meters. Now, it is at 80 meters. So, how much has it covered?
75.
This step is crucial. Many students forget to write this part. Anyway, displacement is there. Force is there. And force is constant. For constant force, work done is equal to F S cos theta. So theta is not there, that means F into S. So 75 into 12. Other method, simpler one. Work done equal to change in kinetic energy. Initial velocity was? At T equal to 0, velocity was?
0.
So there wasn't any kinetic energy at T equal to 0. And at T equal to 5 seconds.
30.
Velocity is 30. So work done is equal to change in kinetic energy. So half m new velocity square minus half m initial velocity square, half m common, new velocity is 30, initial velocity was 0. Again, you can proceed this way. Any doubt?